The long-departed and much-missed Firefly is known for many things, but among them are Joss Whedon's clever use of language. Take one of the show's most iconic words, Gorram. It's an analog of goddamn, and it functions just like goddamn would. You can use it as a straight-up adjective.
You're a Gorram time bomb living with us.
Or as a noun.
I don't give a good Gorram what you think.
It even conjugates well as a verb. In the episode Janestown, the hero of Canton hears the locals sing about his exploits and mutters, Whedon's future is a linguistic mashup of old-timey pseudo-Western English and more refined Mandarin that does more than just provide interesting set dressing. It beautifully mirrors the social customs and classes that exist in the terraformed 26th century. The upper class gets Mandarin. You won't hear a Gorram from Inara or the Tams.
Oh, gossa.
And the settlers and desperados get a very down-to-earth American Westernish dialect.
Ooh, not done yet, youngin'.
Gorram fits Whedon's space cowboy lingo perfectly. It's rough, genteelly euphemistic. You can just about imagine some ranch hand from the 1800s growling it. That would be because it's not Whedon's invention. It predates Firefly by over 100 years. We have evidence of the word Gorram in print back to the 1850s, where it was used exactly the way that Whedon uses it, as a fictional and hyperbolic characterization of Western speech. Fictional is the key word. We don't have any evidence of people using Gorram in actual speech. One 1872 book on American slang notes it's a uniquely Yankee ingenuity, along with galdam and gosh dang, but it mostly shows up in fiction as something called I dialect. I dialect is the use of non-standard spelling for speech, like this. While most of the Gorams that pepper the early 20th century are in stories about backcountry folk, Gorram did see some use in the 1963 courtroom potboiler. Gorram just goes to show that the genius of Whedon's dialogue isn't entirely in its innovation, but in how short he makes the distance between 1857 and 2517. And that's Gorram brilliant.